women's ice hockey in an absolute thriller in the Edward T. Berry Ice Rink on Friday night, taking on Norwich University, ranked 8th in the nation currently. The Beacons fell to the Cadets on the road 10-0 earlier this year, but tonight would be a different story. Early on, the Beacons pouring it on. Sydney Leonard, her third of the season, unassisted against Leocadia Clark, makes it 1-0 Beacons just over 3 minutes into the contest. And then Katie Wilbert, Isabella Henningsen-Brown, finds her in front, and Wilbert buries her fourth of the season. And just like that, the Beacons are already up 2-0 less than 8 minutes into the game. With the Beacons on the power play, though, awaiting a tripping penalty on Isabella Henningsen-Brown, a shorthander by Makai Baptiste, her 14th of the season, would help trim the Cadets' deficit down to 1. And then in the second, Taylor Girard, her 6th goal of the season, 26 seconds in, knots the game up at 2-2. So a brand new ball game in the ice rink. And then Girard, her 2nd of the game, 7th of the season, helps put the Cadets in front 3-2. But the Beacons would swing momentum back in their favor after killing off 3 Cadets' power plays. They would get a goal of their own. Mia Boyd, her first collegiate goal of the season. Hannah McDougal misses the initial shot. McDougal regathers. Boyd up top gets it, gets her first goal of her college career. And just like that, we're tied up at 3-3. The refs would talk it over, looking for goaltender interference, but the call would stand. It's 3-3. And then this is where momentum shifted even more. And Federique Guay gets called for a tripping penalty. And then a few seconds later, Morgan Teft gets called for a tripping penalty. And the Beacons are on a 5-on-3 power play, a golden opportunity to score here. And Margot Butters does just that for her 4th goal of the season from Liz Cramp and Kaylee Kosick right there. Butters on the right side snipes it by Clark into the left side of the net. She's fired up. And the Beacons, just like that, are back in front against the 8th ranked team in the nation, 4-3. Addie Buddington had a chance to give the Beacons a 2-goal lead here, fans on it, and misses wide left. And then Hannah McDougal with a scoring chance off the redirect. Clark turns it away. So it stays 4-3 as we head to the final period. The Beacons playing a little bit back on their heels, trying to prevent the Cadets from getting the equalizer. And Leah Bosch standing tall in net for UMass Boston the entire way through. You see some loose pucks there, but Bosch turning away everything that comes to her. Another Cadets rush here. In front, Bosch corrals it, and they continue to fire away at her in net. Leah Bosch, though, standing tall in goal. Despite giving up 4 goals in this game, she would stop 36 pucks, including 15 in the third period alone. Is another one there with the Beacons down 6-5 as they would pull the goalie to be on the man-up advantage in the final moments. And then you see what I mean by the 4th goal there. And Frederique Guay gets her 8th goal of the season unassisted. It just kind of bobbled around in front, and somehow Guay gets a stick on it, gets it by Bosch, and we're going to overtime. Liz Cramp in overtime with about 3 minutes to go. You see the pass from Boyd right there. Cramp can't corral it, and it's going the other way. But then Leah Bosch, some big saves again. That one in front kicked away. And then with less than 2 minutes to go, look at this one. She somehow gets a glove on it and keeps it out of the goal mouth. We're still tied at 4-all. But then a tripping penalty would help lead to another Norwich University power play and no goal. With 35 seconds left, it was kicked into the net by the Cadets offense. And just like that, it stays 4-4. Closing seconds of this one, and another shot saved by Leah Bosch. She makes 7 overtime saves, and the Beacons, a valiant effort to try and pull home the victory, but they take a tie against Norwich University, 4-4-all. The Beacons, that's their first tie in series history against the Cadets. It snaps their 12-game losing streak against the Cadets, and it's the first time that they've scored 4-plus goals against Norwich University. They also go a perfect 6-for-6 on the penalty kill in the game. The Beacons will close out their 4-game homestand tomorrow afternoon at 3 o'clock p.m. at home, taking on New England College.